of the circuits and different kinds of advantages can be used. This particular CMOS circuit, CMOS type of circuit, it requires mainly n-channel MOSFET transistors to implement the logic using the true and complementary input signals. So if you are talking about this particular CVSL uses n type of devices for true and complementary input signals. True means you are talking about like 0 and 1 complementary signals, true and complementary signals, and also need two p channel transistors at the top to pull up the output high. In order to pull the output to high, we'll be using two PMOS transistors. When all the PMOS are on, definitely the VDD will be will be pulled down to the output so that the output becomes very high. So this kind of logic family is also called as differential cascade voltage switch logic. It's also called as differential cascade voltage switch logic because it is using both the true and complementary input signals at the same time. Differential, we are using two different kinds of inputs, so it is also called as a differential cascade voltage switch logic. So now here, this DC VSL is a ratioed logic style that completely eliminates the static currents. The main advantage of this one is that it eliminates the static currents, and also it provides a rail-to-rail switch. It means that your signal will be moving, or it will be swinging between the high and the low stage of the signal. It means that between whatever the VDD you supply, between that VDD and also the low stage, that's a ground voltage, that's a 0 volts. Between, if I talk about VLSI, the maximum voltage nowadays we are trying to supply only 1 volt, 1 volt or 0.9 volts. So now if that is my high voltage, so it will be your signal will be swinging between that 1 volt and 0 volts to the rail to rail conditions. So that is the top and the lowest point, we call it as a rail to rail conditions. So it provides much higher functionality with greater fan in than the conventional logic. And another advantage of this differential cascade voltage switch logic is that it can even provide good functionality even after having the larger fan in structures also. The major disadvantage of the CMOS logic structure is that whenever you are trying to use more fan ins, then definitely the operation or the functionality will be degraded. But when it comes to this differential concept, even if you supply more number of inputs to the particular design as a fan in, the operation will not be degraded, but you'll be having a good higher functionality. This high functionality allows the number of logic levels and also the gate output nodes to be minimized. The output nodes also will be minimized here. So these are the advantages of this differential cascade voltage switch logic. And this is the design, how it has been connected. You can see, and now you'll be using in the PMOS, both the PMOS have been connected here in a cross-coupled manner. In a cross-coupled manner, both the PMOS are connected here, and this is a VDD. And these are the two outputs. One is a main true output, and the other one is a complementary output. If it is a output dash, means we are calling it as a complementary, and this is a true output. And here in this part, you'll be using the pull-down network, and this part will be the complementary of the pull-down network. It means that if you are using here NMOS, then this particular part will be complementary of that one. Means CNO. You can see one of the example here. If I'm using ABC, now all the inputs for this complementary pull-down network will be opposite of this one. If it is 0, 0, 0, if A equal to 0, B equal to 0, and C equal to 0, then the inputs for this network will be 1, 1, 1. So that is called as a complementary pull-down network. So this kind of designs we'll be using in constructing the differential cascade voltage switch logic. So this is the design of this cascade voltage switch logic. Now let us see. This differential cascade voltage switch logic exhibits higher power consumption. That's a major disadvantage due to the pre-charge state. Whenever you are using a pre-charge state, during the pre-charge stage, it consumes more amount of power. Because of that one, the overall power consumption of this differential switch logic will be more. It exhibits higher power consumptions. It is a clocked switch logic style that is capable of implementing gates with a high fan in. Because of this clock switch logic gate, definitely what happens here, you can use a large number of fan ins Fanon structure can be used, and also this structure achieves low power by restricting the internal voltage swings, in the NMOS evaluation tree without sacrificing the speed. It means that here internally you can reduce the voltage swing by applying some inputs to the NFET logics or inputs over here. You can reduce that voltage swing by applying the inputs over here, and this majorly this can be done with the help of analog process designing part. This is a completely designing part, and because of that one, what happens? You can even the speed cannot be compromised. You cannot, without even compromising the speed, you can achieve low power consumption. Whenever the precharge is high or precharge is low, or improved precharge low topologies are possible with by using this particular differential cascade switch logic. And another advantage is that whenever it is precharge low also, whenever even in the precharge state, if your output is low also, you will be having a superior performance about this DC VSL logic. And this is one of the example of precharge high DC VSL circuit. You can see both the PMOS are connected here. Both the PMOS are connected in parallel here also. This is a similar kind of circuit I have used here. Both the PMOS are connected to that one. The drain of this PMOS is connected to another one structure. And these are the N transistors, which we can see here down. And this is a P transistor. So this is one particular N transistor. And this is another kind of N transistor, N block structures, where for this one, we'll be using the complementary part. And for this one, we'll be using the true values. So now let us see the problems in this one. The problems with this DCSL logic is that large number of NMOS devices have been used here in series, which forces high supply to the threshold voltage ratios. It means that your voltage should be much greater than the 3 times of the threshold voltage. Since you are using the structure in this manner, here if we are using the pull-down networks here, many pull-down networks you can see here, many N transistors have been used in series manner. Because of this large number of series manner, depending on here hardly we can see only 2 or 3 in series structures. But when you talk about different kind of operations or different kinds of functionalities, more N transistors will be used in series. Because of that one, what happens? That will create a threat for the using of larger VDD. When you use a larger VDD, then definitely what happens? More power consumption will be taking place. That's why it will be having the more power consumption. Whenever you're using large number of N devices in series, then definitely what happens? The VDD has to be increased. That the factor of VDD should be almost, it should be very much greater than 3 times of the threshold voltage of the NMOS device. If your threshold voltage is like 0.5 or 0.6, depending upon what are the technology you're using to design the structure, then you should try to make 3 times more value than this for the VDD. It means that if I'm using 0.5, I need to use a VDD of 1.5. 1.5 should be my VDD, but actually one volt VDD is enough in order to drive the CMOS structures, which are designing at like 0.9 technology. That's 90 nanometer technology. So that's one of the major disadvantages. You'll be having like steep spikes have been observed in the outputs. That's another disadvantage of this DCL. Gate is not robust due to its sensitivity due to differences in the output loadings. You know that since I'm trying to input both the true and complementary outputs, it even has got some trade-offs here. The trade-off will be, because of that trade-off, what happens? The gate will not be robust. It will not be performing in a very good manner. The performance will be degraded and the fastness also will be degraded. So for that one, another kind of technology will be used, that is like low voltage DC SL technology has been used in order to solve this kind of problem. And that thing has our syllabus. It's not necessary for us to go ahead for that one. As our syllabus, as per our syllabus, These are the alternate gates which we are to be studied in this concept. In this concept of alternative gates, we have studied what is meant by CMOS logic structure, what is meant by pseudo NMOS logic structure, what is meant by NMOS logic structure, what is meant by dynamic logic structure, domino logic structure, and DCSL logic structure. It means that, like, we have studied nearly 7 different kinds of logic structures, and even this one, pass transistors. We have studied nearly 8 different kinds of logic, alternate logic structures or logic circuits in this particular concept. Okay, thank you for this particular session. If you